Some of you who have visited the museum, which was started by the late Archbishop Nkoyoyo, they depict some of the situations at the time of the killing of the Uganda martyrs. The killing was masterminded by Mukajanga. When you go over there and you look at those images, you come out tormented, I would say. However, when you go outside that museum, you can still watch the scene. And in this time, it is actual. People using machetes to kill others, using spears to spear other people, using guns to kill people, and so on and so forth. I'm not going to repeat what has been mentioned here, what has happened to General Katumba, and we pray for the repose of his daughter and his driver. But those who watched the news last night, I think they showed us about three instances of murder. That which happened to General Katumba, another one happened here in Kampala, another one happened in Ruengo, and they were all using guns. Now, how can we today condemn Mukajanga when there are so many Mukajangas? Does that exist? There are so many Mukajangas in our society. That's why I'm saying, let us pray and work for peace. There are still many people who are detained in places known and unknown. We say, in the name of praying for and working for peace, please release the political detainees or charge them in the proper courts of law. You cannot talk of peace when other people are still languishing. You cannot, when you look at the pictures there in the museum, you know, using machetes to kill people, to butcher them. And yet today you see people who have come from such places of torture. Some have no nails. Others, their fingers have been cut off. Can we say that we are in the 21st century? And we say that in the other 2 centuries ago, this is what has happened to our Ugandans, the believers who were tortured because of faith. But now today people are tortured because of their beliefs, because of what they believe in and what they want to do. So please, let us pray and work for peace in our country and be promoters of peace. Mpadde ekyokulabirako nti tuyinza okubeera wano ne twogera ku byaliwo mu biseera by'abajulizi. Abajulizi nga bwe batulugunyizibwa, nga bwe battibwa. Naye bw'otuukako mu museum walimu ba Enakiyanja, bannaffe aba Church of Uganda, Archbishop Nkoyoyo yaleka atandise museum. Mu ndongo mulimu ebifaananyi ebyagala okutulaga eyakulembera ekikwekweto ekyo ng'ayitibwa Mukajanga kye yakolanga. Ne ŋŋamba nti bw'ogendayo oyinza okufuluma nga weesooza ebyo Mukajanga bye yakola. Naye ate bw'oyisitawo ennaku ntono oba ne kwolwo lwennyini, olaba ng'ebintu ebyakolebwa ku bantu mu ebiseera ebyo bikolebwa ku bantu b'omulembe guno, ng'abantu bakozesa ebijambiya, bakozesa amafumu, bakozesa emmundu okutta bantu bannaffe. Abo si ba Mukajanga. Tunaaba tutya nga tuvumirira Mukajanga bye yakola, ng'ate naffe mu makkati gaffe mulimu ba Mukajanga? Tuleese ekyokulabirako ya General Katumba Wamala, muwala we gwe yadde naye mu mmotoka naye yadde abafuga battiddwa masasi mu ngeri enzibu. Naye ng'eriyo n'abalera bangi be basse. Ngambye eggulo abalabye TV wabaddeyo okutta okw'emirundi esatu wewa General Katumba mu Kampala muno, waliwo we battidde abantu ndowooza 10 babasse n'amasasi. E Ruengo nayo babasse n'amasasi. Kiki ekigenda maaso? Tusabe ate tukolerere emirembe. etemu okutulugunya abantu obulyake bikome bive mu nsi ya feno Uganda era nenkoora abo bonna abo buyinza wali bamanyi nti waliwo abantu abasibibwa mu bifo ebimanyiddwa oba ebitamanyiddwa olw'ensonga z'ebyobufuzi abantu abo babate oba si ekyo babatwale mu kkooti entuufu gye baba bawoozesa emisango gisobole okuggwaawo kati emyezi gyetoolodde abantu abo nga bali mu bifo ebyo basibiddwa abantu abo bakwatibwa mangu ne batwalibwa balina abakyala balina abaana tewaliwo kadde kubalekerawo wadde olukumi ku kameeza tewaafuna kadde ako bamaama b'abaana abo babaliisaala batya balowooze abakulembeze ku mutima ogw'obuzadde basaasire abantu abo babate waakiri basobole okuddayo okulabirira bakyala baabwe n'abaana baabwe tujja kusanyuka nnyo ng'ekyo kikoleddwa abantu abo nga bateereddwa oba batwalibwe ŋŋambye mu kkooti entuufu gye baba bawozesebwa.
A new term of office for the President and members of Parliament has just started. We seek the intercession of the martyrs so that God may enable the leaders to prioritize the fundamental needs of the ordinary Ugandan: health, education, poverty eradication, employment, especially for the youth, the rule of law, observance of human rights, dialogue, national consciousness and unity, the fight against corruption. Those, in my humble opinion, are some of the priority areas that the leaders in this new term need to work on if they are going to get the trust of the people they serve. We are here because Sekabaka Mwanga II passed a death penalty against the martyrs, which, as it turns out, seems to be the seed that germinated, hence spreading Christianity in Uganda and in Africa. Mwanga's great-grandson, Kabaka Ronald Muwenda Mutebi II, who reigns today, calls upon us to work together with mutual respect for one another and with humility so that we let each other uphold the values that define the different communities that constitute the citizens of Uganda. If we let justice prevail, if we go about our responsibilities with integrity, we will promote unity, and the development of the Pearl of Africa will surely come about.
Allow me also add my voice in saying the issues that are raising are being handled. The government that we are in is a very sensitive government. We are going to make sure this is new leadership. We are going to handle whatever has been raised in this celebration. And in the next time we come back, we'll report to you that we deliver the message. We also want to request the public out there, including the people who are here, that elections are over. We urge you, ourselves and people out there, to get united. We need unity in Uganda. We need peace. And as Christians, as religious, we are the ones who are going to preach about this peace that we are talking about. Let's come out truthfully to talk about it, and we implement it. We should not just talk. But as government, we are committed to have reconciliation and forgiveness. As religious people, we will forgive each other, we will reconcile, and we are ready to work with everybody in this country in order to build a better Uganda. As government, we will always continue supporting all the celebrations, especially the Martyrs' Day celebrations. We will continue supporting it. And I must proudly tell the sons and daughters of Mother Mary that I'm a daughter of Mother Mary. And I will always work together with you where need be. God bless you all.